Hi there, it's Kara from the Hooting Pirate. Are you ever stumped at how to use washi? I know you have a lot of washi. I have a lot of washi. This is just a small sampling of the washi I have. And today I've got 21 washi tape ideas for you. And don't forget to stick around to the very end because I have a gift for you as well. All right, so let's not waste any time and let's get right into my 21 ways to use washi in your planner and bullet journal. So what you can do is use washi as a line because it's pretty straight. So you can use it to divide up different spots in your planner like I've done here and over here. And oh, it's funny, I used the exact same washi. I didn't even realize. And so you're going to use it here, wherever you want to separate things. So you've got this box, this box, this box, and you could just make a line to divide it. And you could do that anyway in any planner that you were using. Next up is using washi to decorate, which is probably the most fun, right? So here is an example where I've layered some washi on top of each other. I've cut it into little flags, and I've just used it to decorate and make things pretty. And I think I have a second example here somewhere. Is it here? I think it's here, yes. So in this cluster here, I've added some washi sticking out as just more of a decoration to make things pretty. Number three, that was number two. So number three is layers, and it is in this one. So you see here, I've got some layers here. I put down two different washies layered up to decorate. And then here, I also have layers. I've got three lines of washi on top of each other to make the planner look pretty and more, I don't know, more diverse with a bunch of different colors. And on this one, I've got the layers. Like here, for example, they're layered. You can see that the orange one goes over the turquoise, but you can still see each one separately. But here what I've done is I've got an orange diagonal stripe, and then I've got this notebook paper one, and then I have the gold one. So they're actually right on top of each other. They're layered on top of each other. So that's number three, using washi in layers. Then you can also use your washi to line the top and bottom of your pages. So number four, that's what number four is. So I've done the top of this page. I've got two, they're layered again. I've got two here, but you don't need to use two, you can use one. Here I've just got the leaves. There's another spot here where I've separated, and I've also used them in layers. And then here, I've put it along the bottom, but if you'll notice that this is a lot thicker than that, it's because what I've done is I've just folded the washi onto the other side of the page, because here there's just a tiny little space, and I didn't want the washi to come up to here. I just wanted to cover up that little space. So then I put it here and I flipped it over. You can also trim it, whatever you want to do, if you don't want to have it on the other page, but I just flipped it over. So that's number four, lining the top and bottom of your pages. So that brings us to number five, and that's separating different items in your planner or bullet journal. So this is my version of a bullet journal. I call it for a bullet journal, lack of a better word. So here what I've done is I've got the title here, and then I have the list of all the books I've read in 2017. So I wanted to separate the title from the list, so I put a line of washi here so that it separates. Also, you can see there's washi here and here, and that's sort of a little bonus, a bonus way to use it. It's part of the decoration, but it's sort of like the base, because it's black too, the stickers and die cuts sit on top of the washi, so you can see it sort of has a place for it to rest. Especially here, you can really see that the numbers are sitting on the washi. It's sort of like their base of their design. So that's a really good bonus. Paper clips. Washi makes fantastic paper clips, as you can see here. I've had these for a while, so they're looking kind of ratty. This is actually like fabric washi, but this is regular paper washi. And yeah, they hold up really good. To do it, all you need to do is thread a piece of washi through the clip, and then when you fold them over onto itself, you got to be careful that they line up really good. And then you can sort of pleat this part so that it sticks back into on the curve of the paper clip. It's nice and neat. So you might take a couple tries to get it, but it's really fun to make. Paper clips. Okay, so that was number six, making paper clips. Number seven is mark a page as important. That's the same planner. So here, I've marked this page as important because this is my dream list that I have. And all I've done is taken a piece of washi, ran it along the edge of the page, and then I folded it back onto the other side. But I didn't fold, if you notice, that it comes out, it sticks out, so I didn't fold it right along the edge of the paper, oops, which is here. I've folded it out a little bit, and it does take a bit of, you know, fiddling to make sure that it's straight, but it's really easy once you've done it a couple times. So that's a lot of fun, and I always like to have that because it's really easy. Once you close the book, you know, okay, well, there it is. Instead of going through all these pages trying to find it, it's right there, you know. It's a lot easier to find. So that's number 7. Number 8, mark off a run of days. Like, if your kids are on holiday a certain day, which is what I've done, or, where is it? Or if you have, maybe you're on vacation, or you're going on a trip, some way to mark off, like a run of different days. You can do this on like a daily one as well. A week you can run off this one and the next one, or if you're on a horizontal, you can even run the strip vertical. But here it's just to show these days we're doing such and such a thing, and it's an easy way to mark it all off. 9 is tabs in your planner. Let me just get this one out. It's under another one. So I'm gonna move this out of the way. So number 9. We find that here it is. So 9 is tabs. Now sometimes the tabs don't say what you want them to say. Sometimes the pattern doesn't, either you don't like the pattern or doesn't match the page that you're using. You can cover up what's already there with washi. What I've done here actually is I've used washi and letter stickers because I want it to say something else. You can write it in with a pen or just use the washi as it is. So I'm going to talk about this in a bit, but when I bought this Happy Planner, I bought it in April or something, and I wanted to use it right away, but it started in July. So what I did was took, you'll see here, this is December and this is November, and I took these 2 months from the very back of the book and put them in the beginning, and then so I could use them because I wanted to use it right away, and I knew by the time November, December rolled around, I'd be happy to buy a new Happy Planner. Yeah. So this said November, so I covered up November with washi and then just added in May with stickers because May is shorter than November. Then I needed the washi to help because May wouldn't cover it all up. So if you want, you can cover up the whole tag. You can run the washi, even run 2 strips of washi all this way, and then use your scissors to cut around here, or you can just go where to the edge of the tab, or whatever works best for you. Sorry, I'm still getting over the flu. I'm not quite there yet. Then you can also make your own tabs with washi from where there isn't one. You can fold over washi like we did with the important page. Hold on. Let me get that out and show you again. With this one, it's stuck. But instead of running the whole length of the page, you just do the size of the tab. Or you can run it this way and fold it over that way. With this one, I used quite a wide washi, but you can use whatever you want to make yourself your own tab. Next up is filling in boxes. So a lot of planners have boxes, and sometimes you don't need all the boxes. So in this case, I just happened to have washi that was the exact width of my Happy Planner boxes, so I used that. But what happens if you don't have washi? Like, this one's not the same width at all. So what happens when you have washi that doesn't fit exactly? Then you can go and take a different washi and run strips along here. And a neat trick for this is to do, especially, it depends on the design, but here it kind of mattered because I didn't want it to overlap too strangely. So run the top and the bottom and then work with the middle ones. You can see it sort of overlaps here so that the overlap doesn't wreck your design. You can sort of wiggle with that. But that's a good way to fill in your boxes. So that's number 10. Oh, we're just about halfway there. So next is to line the inside margins of the pages of a ring planner. So this is my little wallet. What I've done was I've just taken these pages out. They're usually boop in there. But you can see that you can line the inside of your rings. It doesn't have to be a ring planner, but it is fun to do the rings. But you can do it on you can do them in here as well if you want it to. So that is that. A lot of people do that already, but I figured I'd add it to my list anyway. Okay, so number 12 is to redate an old planner. So I talked about this a little bit already, that I bought this planner in April, but I wanted to use it right away. So you can see here I've used Washi, and I've covered up the old dates. This is December. So I've covered up December. I've covered up here with a bit of paper and letter stickers. And then I have another example here. I've did the whole bit, but I wanted to just show you this page, where I've covered up not only here the numbers, but I've covered up the month as well, and then covered again with different letter stickers. Jeez, I can't even think. It's the flu, I swear. It takes my brain away. Sorry. So you can use this on a planner that you want to start right away, like I did, or an older planner that you loved and you want to use older pages that you have, but the dates are wrong. So you can just add in the dates, cover up with washi, and then add them in. You can use letter stickers here. You can use a pen. You can do whatever you like. Some washi even has numbers that you can use. All right, next we're going to add in some tip-ins. So here you can see I've got this tip-in. This card is just, I punched it. But you can use washi. I'm just going to find where it is. 13, right here. You can use washi as sort of the hinge. So here I've got this nice Project Life card, and I ran a piece of washi on the back so that it hinges and stays put. And it's been in there since July, and it's not coming out. And you'll see probably a couple more examples as we go through the rest of the ideas, because I use that a lot. I use a lot of tip-ins. Next is to tape in things. Like sometimes you have a card. Let me see if I have one here. I have like a card of some sort with some post-its, so you can tape the card into your planner. But also what I've done is I've taped in some stickers. Now sometimes you'll need stickers, the same sort of sticker sheet. Here I'm marking off when I accomplish my goal each day, which I haven't really been today. This is today. I've been sick. I haven't been walking as much as I wanted to. But anyway, point is that as I accomplish each day, I want to put a sticker here. So I can either paperclip this to the top, which I've done as well, but sometimes paperclips don't stay, let's be honest. So here I've washed it in so that I can actually still see what's underneath, but I can have my stickers handy. So if you have something where you're going to need the same stickers or the same cards or something, you can washing them into your planner temporarily. All right, so we're getting close to the end. What about if you want to cancel something in your planner? Something that didn't happen, but you already wrote it in your planner. Okay, I'm trying to find this one. It's 15. Is it in here? No. Is it in this one? Sorry. It's a lot of tips, guys. A lot of things to keep track of. Hang on, I'll find it. It is here. Look, it was in this one. I knew it. Okay, so here, for example, I had a meeting with someone that didn't happen, so I just wanted to cross it off. So you can either use like a light colored, like this one, for example, a light colored washi where you can see through it, so you know that it was there, but it was canceled. Or what I did, I took a really dark gray, which matched the black of this spread, and actually black is good because it's like, canceled. I like using black to cancel things. But if you want to be able to see what it was you were going to do, you can use a lighter color for that. All right, 16. I saw 16 when I was looking for 15. Here it is right here. So 16 is cover up something you don't like. So here, what I've done is I've got this pattern paper that I really liked, but when I cut it to fit this spot, some of the words got cut off. So I've got half words, I've got half sentences that don't make any sense. So I just took some strips of washi and covered up those little half words, half sentences, so that the rest of the words that are there make sense. Also down here, I'll show you in another page before, it's got this like brushstrokey pink, which didn't really match too well, and I didn't really want it. I wanted to have something more solid, so I've got this little strip of turquoise washi on the bottom to cover up that. So 16 is covering up something you don't like. Number 17 is using using washi as a quote. Now, some washis have words on them, like this one. These are actually foiled up really pretty. But you can use that as a quote or a title or some kind of addition to your planner. So here I've got a little strip of washi, and it just has, oh, and there's another tip in. It's just a little quote in my planner. 18, let's use washi as a label or a header. Now that this one is in here, it's back here. So what you can do is use, I like to use lighter colors because then you can write on top of them, but you can use whatever one you want that fits the space you have. So I've just added a bit of washi, and then with a pen that writes on washi, no, that's not it, sorry, that's not the right pen, I've added my header to my box. So you can use that as a header of a box or a label somewhere in your planner, whatever you want. Next is covering up mistakes. Now, we're all human. I'll make mistakes. It's okay. But sometimes you just want to cover them up. So you can cover it up with washi. What I've done here, well, I had by Juliet a desk, but by was really messy and it was bugging me, so I covered up with a bit of washi and just wrote it a bit neater up here. So you can cover up your mistakes, and it's not a big deal. It's not a big deal, but you know, sometimes you just want to cover them up. Next up is checklists. Now, if you have a design like this one, let me open it up maybe, that's sort of one design in a regular pattern, like these are dots. These are actually really close together, but I'll show you here what I've done. For this coming week, I've got them. These are really close together, but I like to write a lot of things for my week, so that's good for me. But maybe you want something a little more spaced out. You can use hearts, stars, anything that's sort of in a regular pattern, kind of like you know, stickers, the checklist stickers, but with washi. So if you have a washi that has a pattern like that, you can use that really easily. Last one, holy cow, that was quick. So last up is to unite or connect a theme, person, or event. So what does that mean? I don't actually have a specific example because I don't do this myself, but I think it's a really good idea. If you have something that reoccurs all the time, if you're working on a project, for example, or if you have an event coming up, every time you see that, you use the one washi, like this one, for example, one washi per theme or event or project in your planner. So let's say you have a bunch of kids, like me. I don't do this, but maybe I should. I actually have colors for my kids, but let's say you have two kids, a daughter and a son. So this is your daughter's washi, and this is, oops, your son's washi. So every time your daughter has, I don't know, ballet practice or a test coming up or something like that, you're going to use this washi to mark it in your planner, so you know that it has to do with her. And every time your son goes to hockey or he has to go to his friend's house or does something, you're going to use his washi. Let's say you use lots of it, like if there's a whole, you run down a whole page with this, you might run out of the same washi. You probably won't, because most washis are pretty thick. I've used a lot of this and there's still quite a bit left. You can buy two or three rolls of the same washi, or you can just change washi. If you get, maybe by the time you run out of this, you're going to get bored of this one for your daughter. You're going to use another floral or something else that she likes. Same for a project. If you're working on a project, every time you see, like maybe it's this one, every time you see these dots in your planner, you know it has to do with that specific project. Or if you have an event coming up, anything, you can use those to sort of unify or connect different pages, different weeks, different days. You're going to use that same washi each time for that specific event, person, whatever. All right, so give me a little thumbs up if you liked even one of those, if even one of those was new to you and you're going to use it in your planner. I have some bonus ones. I did tell you, I think, one at least, but I have some more. So I use washi all the time for different things. I've actually used I've used washi tape to tape my external hard drive to the back of my computer. I use them for labels. I think I use them on my, if you watched my, what's it called, craft room video from the other day, I use washi tape to label the front of my Alex drawers, which is really, because I can just take it off and relabel it really easily. Brie from Call Me After Coffee came up with this, and I thought it was brilliant because I always have my pens in a cup, and if you look at them, these ones almost look the same, and I'm always pulling out the wrong pen. So now I've got this one flowered washi, and this one has striped washi, so I can tell the difference. It's great if you've got pens that are the exact same pen, but the points, you've got different points. You can't tell if they're in a cup, right? So it's really easy to grab them quickly without having to pull out 75 of them before you get to the one you want. What else have I used? I always have washi in my coat pocket, and I will give, I'll pull off a strip and give it to babies at hockey practice when they're sitting in the stroller and they're bored. I'll just give it to them. The moms think I'm great. I don't know. It's like just what I have in my pocket. If you ever go to, some sort of potluck or somewhere you have to bring a dish, I will wrap washi around like my knife if I need to cut, or the bowl or whatever, so that we can find it really easily, because sometimes if there's something in it, you don't want to lift up the bowl to look for your name underneath. So that's really great. And yeah, there's lots. You can use washi for lots of things besides your planners. So if you like this, don't forget to comment and share with your friends and subscribe, because I'm coming with lots of new videos. And yeah, in the comments, tell me what your favorite tip is that I've used and the one that you're most excited about trying in your planner next. Now, since you stayed to the end, I've got a bonus for you. If you click on the link below, I'm going to send this to your email. It is the 21 ways that I've just gone through in this video, but in a list, so you can print this off, put this in your planner, or stick it on your wall next to where you play in your planner, and so that when you've got what am I supposed to do with all this washi, you've got 21 ideas right there. So don't forget to click that link, give me your email, and I'll send it right off to you. Okay, have a fantastic day, and happy planning, everyone.